Hi everyone, and welcome to Easy Trading Computers. This is our quick tip video series. In each of these videos, I will show you step by step how to perform configurations and customizations to save you time at your trading computer.
In this video, I want to show you how to monitor your computer's CPU performance. In order to monitor your computer's CPU performance, you're going to want to use the Windows Task Manager. There are a few reasons that you'd want to monitor your CPU performance. Number one, to test the general capabilities of your machine. How much resources does it use on a regular basis? From 0% of its power to 100% of its power. Number two, in order to review the performance history of your CPU. In other words, how well does it perform during the varying conditions you experience as you use different applications? Number three, to perform troubleshooting steps. The Windows Task Manager can be your first stop to review your machine's performance when it's not acting in a typical way. Below you'll find the steps needed to find and use the Windows Task Manager in order to monitor your CPU performance. First, right-click on an empty spot on the task bar and then left-click on Start Task Manager from the contextual menu. Next, a new window will pop up. This window is the Windows Task Manager. Left-click on the Performance tab. In the Performance tab, you'll be able to monitor your CPU usage and history. You will also see the physical memory usage and history. It may be helpful for you to know more about what you're viewing on this report. Let's do a quick tour of the Windows Task Manager Performance tab. First off, if you have multiple CPUs, you'll see more than one CPU monitoring graph on this page. Your graph should match the number of processors that you have. On screen now, you'll see two examples of what you might be seeing on your own computer. They both say the same thing, it's just displaying one CPU versus multiple processors within a CPU. Think about CPUs or multiple CPUs like cylinders in a car engine. Some have 4, 6, or 8. Moving on, let's talk about the CPU usage as it appears on the Windows Task Manager. The first breakdown you see is CPU usage. This means the percentage of CPU that is being used right now, and also what's not being used. If you see high percentage of CPU usage on a consistent basis, something could be wrong with your machine. The second thing you see is the CPU usage history. This shows how busy the processor has been. This graph only shows history since the window has been open. So keep that in mind if you're wanting to monitor the performance of your computer for a full workday. The third thing that appears is the physical memory statistics. In this section of your performance window, you'll see a breakdown of how the physical memory that's installed, in other words, your RAM, is being utilized. The first statistic that appears is the total memory. This counter shows the amount of RAM, in other words, random access memory, that is usable by the operating system, or OS as it's referred to. This is used to perform tasks. There will be a difference between the total memory that you have installed on your machine and the total available for the OS. A certain amount of physical memory gets mapped and dedicated to other computer functions. As a result, it's not available in this total number. The next thing that appears is cached memory. Cache is pronounced just like money, C-A-S-H, just spelled a little differently, isn't it? This is the sum of the memory being used to temporarily store data that's currently being processed a lot. The goal of this memory is to reduce the average time it takes to access certain data in the future, like a few seconds from now. The next statistic is your available memory. This is the amount of physical memory available for the operating system to use. Another statistic is free memory. This is the sum of the memory that doesn't contain any valuable data right now. This will be used first when the processes on your computer or drivers or the operating system needs more memory. The final thing is a bit of a nerdy term, which is kernel memory. Basically, all you need to know is this is the memory used by the operating system to deal with the data going on behind the scenes. So again, use this Windows Task Manager dialog with the Performance tab enabled for viewing to see how your computer performs under heavy load. Use it to find out which programs are taking up resources. One final tip that I'd like to give you is how to quit tasks that are stuck and taking up too much resources. When you're viewing the Windows Task Manager, or you're concerned about the Performance tab report, the graph showing CPU usage is exceptionally high and continuously high, then it may be the case that one of your applications is stuck. Just use Control-Alt-Delete in order to quit any programs that you have identified are taking up too much CPU resources.
I hope this quick tip helped you today. Thanks for watching this video at Easy Trading Computers, and we'll see you next time.